can only imagine what it will be like when I walk by your side. I can only imagine what my eyes will see when your face is before me. I can only imagine. Surrounded by your glory, what will my heart feel? Will I dance for you, Jesus, or in awe of you be still? Will I stand in your presence, or to my knees will I fall? Will I sing hallelujah? Will I be able to speak at all? I can only imagine. I can only imagine. I can only imagine when that day comes and I find myself standing in the sun. I can only imagine when all I would do is forever, forever worship you. I can only imagine, yeah. I can only imagine. Surrounded by your glory, what will my heart feel? Will I dance for you, Jesus, or in awe of you be still? Will I stand in your presence, or to my knees will I fall? Sing hallelujah. Will I be able to speak at all? I can only imagine. Yeah, I can only imagine. Surrounded by your glory, what will my heart feel? Will I dance for you, Jesus, or in to my knees will I fall? Will I sing hallelujah? Will I be able to speak at all? I can only imagine. Yeah, I can only imagine. I can only imagine. Yeah, I can only imagine when all I would do is forever, forever worship you. I can only imagine.
If I had only known the last time would be the last time, I would have put off all the things I had to do. I would have stayed a little longer, held on a little tighter. Now what I'd give for one more day with you. There's a wound here in my heart where something's missing, and they tell me that it's gonna heal with time. And I know you're in a place where all your wounds have been erased, and knowing yours are healed is healing mine. The only scars in heaven, there won't be to me and you.
such thing as broken, and all the old will be made new. And the thought that makes me smile now, even as the tears fall down, is that the only scars in heaven are on the hands that hold you now. I know the road you walked was anything but easy. You picked up your share of scars along the way, but now you're standing in the sun. You fought your fight and your race is run. The pain is all a million miles away. The only scars in heaven, they won't belong to me and you. There'll be no such thing as broken, and all the old will be made new. And the thought that makes me smile now, even as the tears fall, scars in heaven, yeah, are on the hands that hold you now. Goes by that I don't see you. You live on in all the better parts of me, until I'm standing with you in the sun. I'll fight this fight and this race I'll run, until I finally see what you can see. Oh, the only scars in hell won't belong to me and you. There'll be no such thing as broken, and all the old will be made new. And the thought that makes me smile now, even as the tears fall down, is that the only scars in heaven are on the hands that hold you now.
I love you, Lord, pray it happens like that. I bet you're up there right now, making plans and writing out all your favorite places that you just can't wait to take us, and we'll get to spend forever talking about whatever. When I get there, promise you'll track me down and show me
lau fiele man malo le ri ngai kayao lau pale maile il ka ko onsai e oleve i ngai pe o fale kong o lo faka kari maile le ka vale mol mol maier king or kinga kong ol mao ko falsal ti ia mal falo al
of gold. I've only read about what you've seen, what you know, and I'm still here missing you. Oh, I wonder what you're getting into. I bet you're up there right now, making plans and writing out all your favorite places that you just can't wait to take us, and we'll get to spend forever. But you're up there right now, making plans and writing out all your favorite places that you just can't wait to take us, and we'll get to spend forever talking about whatever. When I get there, promise you'll track me down and show me.
Looking back from the other side, I can see now with open eyes, darkest water and deepest pain. I wouldn't trade it for anything, 'cause my brokenness brought me to you, and these wounds are a story you'll use. So I'm thankful for the scars, 'cause without them I wouldn't know your heart. And I know they'll always tell of who you are. So forever I am thankful for the scars. Now I'm sending in comfort.
I'm thankful for your scars, 'cause without them I wouldn't know your heart. And with my life I'll tell of who you are. So forever I am faithful. I'm faithful. There's a peace I've come to know, though my heart and flesh may fail. There's an anchor for my soul. I can say it is well. Jesus has overcome, and the grave is overwhelmed. The victory is won. He is risen from the dead, and I will rise when he calls my name. No more sorrow, no more pain. I will darkness breaks to light, and the shadows disappear, and my faith shall be my eyes. Jesus has overcome, and the grave is over. My name, no more sorrow, no.
Let's all rise for the procession.
Yeah, lala mai lala mal falo at. Olha ka oko ia fa maeng il tai lotol nei tai au. Su lau fenga ruenga tofi le tua e mesele tai tai sau nginga nei tai au. Pa ia o a inga unga tu te tele mauna tu tau langi. E sau paolo. Tupu foi. Ia o te marua e fakulo waku. Oko pa ia mau kou sa, mau kou fai ngā. O la leo eis fam talanga. Hai tauange ia ngau fatulo watu. Ili ngai kai au. Ke mga akpura pa ia lau fia, leo wau whanga po poto le nei tai au. Leo ke whawhelo e kuai, ia o tau, mā lor soi fua maua, mā lor langi mā, mā ka kuwhero inga, mā malu lea kua ringe yasu. Leo wau kako whakasi, wāna wha mui mori ki ngā, ia Amerika. Mori a kuele nganga whawhka, ia a ungei whai msui o mako ainga, ia lang fua. Mela inga whai kele, mā lea pionga, ia sere ngā le sumai mo maluia. Ia upa ia ngā la whanga o mako ngū, e a fio ai mau pū sūu sori, sūka mā whārufi, ai pui pui maru whetta lainga lako whā. Leo wa mau lunga ai mā pui pui, i ngei le malaya lupilele, e fio ai la fionga pū ngē fulmok, melea, la wha le wha au mies mako whamklanga, o wan ngei keimi, le la aku waku na kusunga le wha pengainga, kai ka ia kapsau nginga, alo ia u whaiba, ia wāle, le wha moe moe malea, le loko fa ma vai le king ai Mary ia mal falo al ken
at this time we'll begin the viewing. Go ahead and do the video while the viewing takes place.
with every song we could ever sing. Worthy of all the praise we could ever bring. Worthy of every breath we could ever breathe. We live for you. Jesus, a name above every other name. Jesus, the only one who could ever save. Worthy of every breath we could ever breathe. We live for you. Oh, we live for you. Holy, holy, there is no one like.
Like you. Can't reach you, but Sister Mary.
I decided to help out with the rest of the services. Continue to pray, you know, for Nathan, her son, and her grandsons, Stephen and Zion, and Deb, their mom, Nathan's wife. And I'm glad to know that they were able to get on the plane and be there for that, for her service. How important it is, that was the one thing that we all were praying so hard for, is that Nathan, you know, would make it there. For her, for his mom's special day, and it's gonna be a special day. It's gonna be a wow, you know, service, one that's gonna be unforgettable, because, you know, in our hearts, you know, and to a lot of people, she's unforgettable, and that's the love that she had in her heart for Christ. And so, we just want to say thank you for all of you. Help my sister in whatever way it was. Part of her life, a true blessing from God. Just thank God for this opportunity we can share.
You can probably edit that into a, after, you know, doing your...
Unforgettable.
Oh, yeah, the one line.
Yeah, well, you're talking, yeah. Yes, yeah. Yeah. She is unforgettable.
Yeah.
That's what
is, and what I, you know, and what I want to share too is because, you know, the last time we had practice, well, the last time she was here, and then I had to take her home, and she, before I left, she said, brother, Whether I have or not, let's just pray. So we pray then, that Tasha, as you said, she prayed with me and asked me, accept Jesus Christ in your heart, come into your heart. And that night, I said, my case is
fixed.
That was your mission.
Unforgettable to me.
That was part of her mission. So to make sure I had accepted Christ. And that was part of her mission.
So that, you know, she knows that she would see you again.
She wanted to make sure that I was.
Yeah, she was so excited. She came home, she told us what happened. You know, and we all rejoiced. For you, brother, we all rejoiced. Praise the Lord, right? We're all going to see you again.
We're going to see you again, Mary.
Yes.
Yes.
All right. That's a wrap.
It's time for coffee.
Yeah.
We can probably edit that into a, after you're doing your...
I'm gonna miss you so much, Mary.
And,
Jesus,
before I left,
I'm gonna miss you
forever.
Mary, I know where you are. You're with Jesus. Thank you for everything. Love you, Mary.
Heaven, like, let's just pray. So we pray that. As you said,
Mary, I know you're
here. You prayed with me.
And I love you.
That was part of her mission. To make sure that I had accepted her. And that was part of her mission. So that, she would see you again. She wanted to make sure that I was. She was so excited. She came home, she told us what happened. You know, and we all rejoiced. For you, brother.
Praise the Lord, right?
We're all going to see you again.
We're going to see you again, Mary.
Yes.
All right.
That's a wrap. It's time for coffee.
Still the best is okay. The sweetest, the best. God bless you.
Thank you for coming. By your
side, I can only imagine what my eyes will see when you face.
Hi, Mary. Miss you.
Mary, thank you so much for everything. I love you.
Will I dance for you, Jesus? Or in all of you be still? Will I stand in your presence? Or to my knees will I fall? Will I sing hallelujah? Will I be able to speak at all? I can only
see my husband. Okay? Bye. Love you.
Say hello to everyone at the airport. Hello. See you up there.
Thank you.
goodness. I wish you and Dad had gotten together, but not to be. Love you.
Oh, Nathan.
Oh, well, that's all Nathan. I do
is forever.
It's okay.
Forever it's okay. Worship you. I can only imagine.
Hey. You know, Malanga. Say hi to my mom when you see her up there. Gonna miss you.
My sister, I could.
I need you.
Love you, Mary. Miss you. Oh. I can't reach. Say hi. Just touch her because she can't reach. My son's skull.
Thank you guys for coming. Thank you for the baby. Beautiful.
Bye, Susie. Okay, I'm Lady Mary. Mary, my name is Oxford.
Hi, Mary.
Oh, fine.
Yellow Malanga. Hey, you be okay, man?
Yeah, good.
Good to see you, man.
You too.
Okay.
I'm in.
Okay. Yellow Malanga. See you soon. Love you. Get rich.
Fight this fight in this race I'll run until I finally see what you can see.
Thank you.
The only scars in hell.
Thank you for everything.
You won't be honest with me.
Hey, thank you guys. For the work you
do. There'll be no such thing as broken.
Biro mo lang natin, shish. Biro mo lang.
Good morning, everyone, and welcome. Praise God for this wonderful occasion that we can gather like this to honor God and to honor the life that was spent in serving Him. Let's begin in a word of prayer. Let us pray. Father God, we are so thankful today for the answered prayers, God, for your favor. As we prayed, Lord, for fair weather. But God, you know we are always dependent upon your favor, your grace, O God, and your mercies. And so now, Lord, as we begin, Lord, this service, we commit this time to you, O God, that you be exalted in every way, that you be lifted up. This we do pray now in Jesus' name. And everybody says, amen. Amen.
Oh, Scripture reading for today is in the book of Psalms, chapter 23, verses 1 through 6. I'll read the odd number verses, and congregation, please respond with the even number verses. Please rise for the reading of his word. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He restoreth my soul. He leadeth me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of mine enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil. My cup runneth over. Praise the Lord for his goodness. Y'all may be seated.
Songs. That first one was one, and this second one is one also. It's all about God. We worship you.
Thank you.
Praise the Lord. This time we're going to begin the eulogy. We'll ask Sheba, she'll come up to start.
We are so blessed to see all of you, to come here and to honor the Lord first and foremost, and our sister Mary Malaulu. I am her sister, Sheba Sangyao, and the Bible says that God, He is a God of the living, not a God of the dead. So Mary is alive, but she is not here with us. She is with the Lord. She just changed her address. You know, she's no longer living here on earth, but she's with the Lord. And that's where we all want to be one day. You know, and that's the purpose of, you know, God doing that work in each one of us as He did in Mary. You know, Mary is, she's my older sister, and there's four girls, and she was the boss. She was the one that ordered us and made us do all her, you know, everything that she wanted done. She would always... Sheba, Naomi, and Lena. We would do everything for her. And so that's what we lived with, you know, Mary as being 6 years older than I am. But as we grew older and we got to know our places and realize in 1977, this is one of the biggest accomplishments that can happen in a person's life. And that is getting a B.A. Now, a B.A. is a born-again degree, all right? Born again. That's how we come here, being born through our parents. And the only way we're going to get to heaven is by being born again. And so Mary, my sister, you know, her life was one of just loving. And people, you all know, you all know how Mary was. You know, she gave her heart and she gave her time. She was just so filled with joy. And that joy did not come from her. It came from the Lord. You know, God has blessed all of us with the joy of the Lord. You know, He has blessed all of us with, we're all special. And He has given all of us gifts, just as He has given Sister Mary the gift. And the gifts that she went out, and didn't matter who you were, she would talk with you. And many here, she's prayed with you. And she may not even know you. I was with her at Ace the other day, and we ran into a sister. And right there, she would, you know, we hear something going on in their lives. And right away, that was Mary. She started praying right there in the store and anywhere in the bank. She worked for a development bank for many years. And... one of the funny things she told me is one day she went to work, and that time Utu was the president, and so she goes into Utu's office, and she has the tag on her top that says the size of your. She forgot to take the tag off, and she's going into his office, and he was so embarrassed for her that. You know, he was just saying, tell her to take that off, you know. And, you know, she's just such a funny person, a joyful person, a beautiful sister in the Lord, a beautiful daughter, you know. And, you know, the story of Mary and Martha. Well, sometimes I can say Mary is who she was. Mary, she sat at the feet of Jesus. And sometimes I can be a Martha. I'm doing all these things, and I'm getting distracted and doing this and doing that. And, you know, but Jesus told, you know, Martha that Mary chose the right. She sat at Jesus' feet and learned, you know, from God. And so I know you have many stories, you know, that you have in your heart, you know, times that you met. She was your best friend when you needed a best friend. You know, she was ears when you wanted to share something, and she was there to share and to love, and that was Mary. You know, and I'm so thankful that I had a chance to be here in Samoa with her, because when I found out that we were going to come to Samoa, you know, I wasn't too happy in 1988, and I was we were going to go to Kananafou, and I was, you know, we can get so in the flesh, we can get so, you know, stubborn, but Sister Mary, you know, I didn't go to the last service, and my dad's the Faife out there in Huntington Beach, he was, and Mary came over to my apartment, and she, you know, sat me down and just talked, and she prayed. She was a praying woman, a praying warrior. That's like my mom, a prayer warrior. You know, and that's what we all need to realize, that Jesus is coming soon, and we need to stay close to the Lord. Now, I have the video that I want to close it with, that you want to watch, and it's Sister Mary, and she's sharing right here. And if you can show that, and I just want you to hear from her. Thank you, in Jesus' name.
Chapter 1, verse 16. For I am not ashamed of the gospel of Jesus Christ, for it is the power of God unto salvation to everyone that believes, to the Jew first and to the Gentiles. That's you and me. We have been made good to be engrafted into the vine of the Jewish family. Isn't that exciting? Yeah, that's right. And so, along with that, all of you, listen up. God has not given you a spirit of fear. What I've been hearing from up here is just courageous going onward to 2020. There's no need to fear. There's no need to be afraid of their faces, because God has given you everything, everything that you need to stand, and to stand tall, and to stand strong on the word of God. That will last forever and ever and ever. Everything will pass away, but the word of God will stand. So we just went into the future. I go, what? Says, yes, we're already in 2020. Oh, well, yeah, we're in Japan. Oh, Japan? Okay, find me a samurai. But I want to tell you, God is just so, that was so exciting when I heard their voices wishing me, their grandma, a happy new year. And that's what all the blessings are. You grandmas know, your moms and dads know, brothers and sisters, family is everything. And I love my sister, Shiva. Shout out. My sisters in California, my nieces, they have the audacity to surprise us again. Oh my God, but I just want to put a shout out to you all. It is time to represent. It is time to show who you are, just like what the brothers have said before me. Do not be ashamed. So what if they look kind of weird to you? That's okay. But I want to tell you something. I want to share that the fragrance of God's love and God's power will just embrace you, that when you pass them by, that they will turn their heads, because they know something powerful, something good, and something right is in this place. And that place is Jesus Christ in you, the hope of glory. Hallelujah.
At this time, we're going to begin our testimonials, and we'd like to call up Brother Lai, and he can begin our testimonials.
Mumulaba Vaftaida Lofale Tua Neyasumatang of Fiwa Tato put putwai in Ne sounding a sounding a foyole to a fine Uso Tina Tangatal Neye Kalesia Embolia Twilanganga Faftai Tupu Mai Ela Tunu Olo Pot Potomai. I may say le, nay sounding a toy sounding ole, or itina. While I've met tupuyo tato tangata, or met tato silophium tato lauloa, a little tato. Ole a tua lunga, oile silsiliese, oile pule yo tato soi fuanga, bo fair loves melo tato yai. Oile love a le tato ifo yai, matato fata tari yai. Alo tato yale neiso I fuanga. Ina ua ho o stemi fape. Walao ma yale na fio. Semea te, semea fafu se, mea foi wa. Faa, ole longa le, mea o tangata. Peole tua fine. Te I foi awa. For folks young of Fanga Mlanga, if I pay Mlanga to Lungais, I America. Or the other Fanga Mlanga, Saidi Linga, or the mayor of Wauna, or the matter of Fale Tonu, wa Aliadi my foe, wa Longona Yate, and they tell you what Faina say, as Kenny Post Meva Pella, Pao Lunga Walla Yawala, or the two Langa Nana, Nafufu Aile. Le tua fine va pe fa ya tu san fa nga mlanga ilungai I America ya utau nu te utu o atu fatasi ma no foiele se tasi foio o te major fa na a mese le tamaya jazz ma si olato ai nga ilunga lave I isveo Ya, yeah, me lunga, ya. Yeah. Savalia 42 langa I mesele. Fatu langa ingi ol mesa fai malanga tuai. Na manuia le, ta otonga. Manuia foia, tu langa sa o yona, yona mata. Ya, yeah, alu alua. Te foiwa. Fai fat singa. I mesele mo as fa yulaima. Tu langa va pena, ya. Yeah. No atu umai ol melae. E yai ma o martina la inga ma to fatasi ta fao finite tal non ya ma pelo inga la vai ma sania ya mese mo ainga ya o foi de si vai tau a mata na lue asiasi na isio ainga ilunga o atu lois ane eko asiaile tausi alang foina ya ime la Tartar noa fatas, ya mai a foi na, o at foi desi, fai tu, da yele, iti nam tu a foi le, seisio u antio, fia tangata, kusa wa ivas fulu matolu on tausanga, la feiluai, mo a foi se, maftanga matang o fie, tu lang la vapena, na uia la fele, tu a fine, ya o foi na u vapere, E la sauni e fa pe toi foi mai. Ya, yeah? Sauni foi e fa pe a mese fio o mai. I ya wei e lo ya elia. Shantamo neite ma shanto lua ma na yana grandkids e to lua. Ya, yeah? Fai foi de fofanga sauni taunu ma ya wei. Ya o mai foi ya wei sa ya foi se tasio tina. Na so soni tau singa o matou nei au matou iti. O le silomutua no ya avea sin sato. Se tina foi mai moni ana no foi le ile tama loa sapani ya e se si foi mai o le moto. Pale asao. Tu sai valus valus fuma valus valus I a tau sanga lon soi fuanga. O lo na manuia foi a tea ya na yei foi sfeira ina matango fie male. Male tina. Ya, yeah, I won't fall in love, yeah. sauni fa petoe fo i mai nei i le tonu ya na fa to family ma le te li ma fa na o ma to lua ya fa malanga mai nei o le mea la tu fasili ai se ana la tuai le tina o le mea na tu fasili a o nei o nofo nofo ma o fasili a te ulavia. Why is it that she came up at this time in her life? And it wasn't Elifa Peon Matalan a lot to Otoilei. You know, the Lord has ways of doing things in our lives. It was utilized for Pe Faonga and Latuit Otoyono Mata. Ailei, Olanga Malanga, Fa to Fa. O le mea leo la ngona I ata I tanei. Na uia tu langa wha apea, e wha o ngai o na mata, e o atu e wha tau whai, iai, ia matou nei, I ona tu ngane, I ona uso, I ona tina matua. O le mea la nga ta te nofo ma fau fau anga iai. O ai tatou le tu fisili ai, la sango leo langa o tangata. Ia. Me ala fa pena e ai se fa iupu leole tu si mai tu se Jacopo e fa penei ae le iloa e outou pesea le mea e tupu ata eau. We do not know what's going to happen tomorrow. No one here to tasirana no sisi dese awa pesea e lo outou ola. Asking yourself a question, what is your life? O le alo so I fuanga. O au mea fai. O au mea lai te fata si ai malu wa inga. A wo, e tō mā sangi, me tū langa la whapena. Le matang o fia ngā le tua ma fa so so ina, o le o langa mō tātou uma nei lava. It's amazing that how graceful is his love, that we are blessed with what he has given to all of us. You know, and that's the spirit that's always there. And that's another thing with Calvary Chapel, and I have to thank my brother-in-law, who is the pastor here, you know, for the work that he has done, especially here in Calvary Chapel on the Rocks. And it's not an easy task. But anyway, as we go on, you know, and it's a question in regards to what is your life. The next thing is that it is even a vapor that appears for a little time, and then it vanishes. You know, it's like a little steam, you just puff, and it's gone. And that's what life is. You know, if we don't enjoy life, enjoy each other, what is it? Well, that matter now. A fai tato le, so swani le tasi le tasi po alava tu langa le langa o lo iai. Hey, o le langa ngau tato, o le so swani a yese me o tupu ya le, hey, I'm fine if so sonny, eh? My yoi. Our tough you fear for pair, or is it you what I owe? Now what I owe, Lucyaso for pair, a mountain or no. Tomorrow is never blessed, I mean, it's never promised to anyone. No one at all. And that's, you know, man, I, that's all no for my for fawa, eh? Bail out you to a finit. You know, now let you lungai fatu fa, yamatun, eh? And that goes really close to my heart. On that trip up there, there was something that happened which I regret. We had a little setup for Pemako, Fakasiolo Fale, Fayez Mako Meko Mafa, to have a little bite to eat. So we waited. You know. Now I'm a person of very impatient at times. That when I wait too long, I get a little irritated. So when it did happen, they arrived. It was about 4 hours later. I happened to stand up, and I think I went and ran a chore, you know. And then I came back, and basically we had our little dinner and our little mafkama. So, you know, things went on that day. Lo and behold, a couple of days later, you know, she came back and with, you know, someone else and came back and apologized to me Now, who am I? Here it is, she came to visit. Who am I to expect that out of someone that took her time to come and visit? You know, that's something I would never be able to live down. Kulang fa pela, fa ngongwai lo ngik ngaka. Ufa maulunga, ali kau ngoyai. Aisha, me fa pela le yakako. You know, awale kako fa pela. Oi, usi me ili kakau ngakufa. Kuanga fa pela. No, listen. But those are the things that we kind of look at it again, look at ourselves. Are we living the right track? Are we going the right way? Are we helping those that need help? You know, these are the things that we look at it. And my sister has always asked a question, not to me, but to the others of my sisters. And she always asked them, how is Big Brother Lai? You know, and they say, oh, he's okay. How is Big Brother Lai? And the one wish that I know she has always had, that I have accepted the Lord as my Savior and everything else that goes with it. And that's the thing that, you know, for, with all of us, kako umalava lo kako yele ngay fale, o le kuor kako kai kai, o yang fayo kako ngay kaka, o ye fo inga po alava me kupu yake kako, ya fa peng alava un kako sa vari ire ngay olanga, vavai lalo lang vavai nga, makulanga, e ala mayay po le ale, kulanga fale, e kupu ya kako, ya, ele o tato, o ye lava e ala mayay, o ye fo ito fa fo yay, ya o Yesu, o no, lo na lofa, lo ngal nei, o tato pot poto ai, manuia le nei lavaso, tai lava.
Good morning.
Morning.
So we'll go ahead and start off with the grandkids. Who wants to go first?
Me.
Okay, let's see.
I'm tiny.
Can you guys see us? All right. He's gathering the courage.
Good morning. My name is Zion, and I'm 8 years old, and I'm my grandma's youngest grandson. I'm going to share some of my memories of my grandma. She liked to go to Starbucks, read the Bible, and eat out together.
What'd you say?
Oh, okay. My grandma was always friendly and godly. When she came to visit us in Hawaii, Sometimes she would walk to get her coffee, and she would meet people and tell them God's word. One time she showed me a picture of a friend that she just met at McDonald's. And I asked, "Who's that?" Then she said, "That's the person I shared God's word with." Things I'm going to miss about my grandma are making pancakes together, getting food together, play word games on her phone together. And I will remember that I'll see her in heaven. Thank you for listening.
Good morning.
Good morning.
My name is Thaden, and I'm my grandma's oldest grandson. I'm 10 years old. I'd like to share some memories I have of her with you. One of my memories is whenever she'd stay with us in Hawaii, she'd wake up early in the morning to go get coffee. I would always wake up and see her drinking it while FaceTiming family or eating breakfast. It seemed like she couldn't live without coffee. She loved her coffee and I loved her pancakes. I enjoyed helping her make them in the kitchen. I not only liked when I helped her in the kitchen, but I felt good when the pancakes were in my stomach. The last memory I'd like to share with you is in Hawaii at a place called, or in an area by a street called Lagoon Drive. We were skipping stones in the ocean. That's the place where she taught me and my brother Proverbs 3, 5, and 6. She taught us a song and hand motions to go with it too. Trust in the Lord with all your heart. Lean not on your own understanding. In all your ways acknowledge him, and he will make your path straight. I'll miss her love for me and my brother, and sharing meals with her, getting Jamba Juice, and talking with each other. I'm very grateful I got to meet and know her. Thank you for coming to my grandma's celebration of life.
Good morning. I'm Nathan's wife. My name is Deborah Fisowai Malaulu. I had the honor of marrying her pride and joy and giving birth to her two hearts, as she would call them, her two grandsons. I know when we first got married, it was difficult for her to let go of her one and only, but over time, she's, you know, got used to it, and she really treated me like her own daughter. I mean, so many testimonials about her being kind and loving, generous, and just sacrificing her time to help and serve others. And one of our last conversations together at my church in Hawaii, I was in a women's study in 1 Corinthians. And we were talking about, it was about marriage and being single. And I just shared with her how wonderful it was for her to be single and how that was a gift from God and how She fully used that gift to serve him. And whenever we come back to Samoa, we can see it because everybody comes up to us and they can't say enough about how generous she is, how much of her time she gives, how loving she is. And just being here on island, you know, it's a testimony to the life that she lived, because just going to take care of certain things when your loved ones pass away, you go and take care of certain things at certain offices. And once her son Nathan says, "Oh, my mom is Mary Malauulu," like, "That's your mom? Oh, Kalafai." And, you know, they just, everybody knows her. Everybody loved her. Everybody we come across has nothing but wonderful things to share about her. And so I guess the one thing that I'll miss most about her is her visits to Hawaii and just our time sharing in God's word together. In Proverbs, it says, "Iron sharpens iron," just as one man sharpens another. And just sharing in God's word together has encouraged me in my faith. And I'm so thankful for the time that we've shared together and the grandmother that she's been to my children. Samoa is never going to be the same, but I know for a fact that we will meet again in heaven. Thank you.
All right. You know, there were so many things I wanted to say, but I couldn't really focus on one thing, a flood of emotions and things like that. And as I came up here, I had a chance to share the sermon last Sunday, and I kept getting choked up because I kept on seeing faces that reminded me of my mom. And so I asked Uncle Oscar, Pastor O, you know, "Hey, what do you do?" And he said, "I just stare at the top of the heads so you don't catch eyes," because every time I caught people's eyes, I started crying. But I just jotted a few things down to help keep me on the, like my mom likes to, she's long-winded when she shares sometimes, and she fakes like she's coming in for a landing, but she goes back up and keeps the conversation going. So I can tend to be like that. So I have some notes to kind of keep me directed. But definitely want to, you know, with you know, with all of our heart, we'd like to welcome you. And I feel so humbled. I know if my mom was here, she'd be touched. She'd be humbled as well, you know, just by your presence. But just seeing how much everybody has given, all the things that have transpired within the past, you know, month or so, with everything just coming together, and then everyone just being here, and those that are watching, you know, on the live stream. Thank you. You know, with every part of my heart and my family, thank you. Thank you for being here with us and celebrating my mom's life. I know, like I mentioned, if my mom was here, she'd be definitely be touched and blessed. But in case you just came, you don't know me, I'm Nathan Malauulu. I'm my mom's favorite son. And I oftentimes like to share that, but I oftentimes leave out the fact that I'm her only son, even her only child. But I guess that would make the opposite true, that I'm also her least favorite son, maybe. But I think I like the idea of being her beloved son better. There's never a moment where I did not feel loved by my mom. Even when she was mad at me, scolding me, and disciplining me. I felt the love. Sometimes the love hurt, especially on the backside. But it helped make me to who I am today. And so I'm so thankful for my mom. Thanks, buddy. But, you know, although I am her only son, her only child, she has also been the second mom to many of my family members, my cousins. Who I think of as my my brothers and sisters as well, because, you know, just all through the thick and thin that we've been through, and just everything they've done for my mom. And she's, you know, one of her many titles, and I think it's one of her famous and most beloved titles, Auntie Mary. Of course, to my cousins, she's Auntie. But to so many other millions, she's been Auntie Mary for so long. And it's a fitting title because she treats you like family. You know, she wears her feelings on her sleeve, her heart on her sleeve, and she loves on you. But then when you need to be scolded, she's not afraid to give you a scolding. When you need to be told what is right, she's not afraid to tell you what is right. But at the same time, you know, loving on you as well. She's also a loving sister to, of course, Uncle Lai and the rest of their siblings, but she has so many, you know, sisters and brothers in Christ here and abroad, all around. Her family here, and I have a hard time looking up because when I see faces, they remind me of my mom. Every relationship she's had meant something to her. If you knew her, if you had a conversation with her, if you know you had a hug with her, that meant something to her. She would call us up all the time on Facebook, you know, say hi to the boys, especially that's the main part, say hi to her grandkids. But she would tell me, okay, this is what's going on, you know, at the church, you know, and I talked to so-and-so today, we prayed, and she didn't go into too much detail, so don't be embarrassed if you think, oh, Nate knows, I don't know everything, I just know that she loved you. And that's why last Sunday when I kept looking up, I had a hard time, because when I see you, I see my mom, I see the relationship she had with you, I see her face, I see her love, I see her heart. You know, her church definitely was her second family, but you guys just were her family. And people she came across, like my boy Zion was saying, we actually went to McDonald's not too long after, and this guy was waving at my mom. And you know, like, Mom, who's that? Oh, you know, that's Bill, you know. And I met Bill last week, you know, and found out that, you know, his wife had passed away, and, you know, he's living with his daughter and this and this. And she knew the whole story just from one meeting. And she's like, so pray for Bill, because he's going through this, this, and that. You know, every meeting wasn't just by chance. She had a heart for you, and she had a care for you. And her desire was to connect with people, but it didn't stop there. Her desire was those people that she connected with was to connect them with the Lord. And that was kind of like her life's mission. I remember after she retired and she was kind of pulling out of some of the ministries she's been involved in. And she was like, Nate, I don't know what I'm going to do, what my purpose is as far as ministry. And she shared, she always shared about talking and reaching out to people. I said, Mom, that's your ministry. We, all of us here that have been touched by her life are her ministry. We are her mission field. And she would, on her way up to Cali to visit all the rest of the family, you know, she stopped by Hawaii and hang out with us. And she's like, okay, Nate, I got to go meet Uncle Lai, Uncle Me'e, Auntie Nina, Auntie Omi. And mention all the aunties, all the cousins, because I really want to share this with them. I really want to encourage them. So if they didn't know the Lord, they were going to come to know the Lord, or at least have that opportunity when she met them. If they did know the Lord, she was going to encourage them in the Lord. And that's every time she went up with the purpose is to share the love of God, to share her heart. And then when I come back here, it's the same thing, you know, especially on the FaceTime calls. It's, oh, I had a chance to talk to sister so-and-so. I had a chance to talk to brother so-and-so. And, you know, be able to encourage and share. But at the same time, she was encouraged by you. She was encouraged by all of us. She was built up by the things that we were able to share as well. there's a verse on the sign or also on the program. And I kind of was just looking for a verse to put on. And I said, okay, this sounds like a cool verse. But I just feel like that verse is so fitting, you know, to explain or to describe my mom's life. Philippians 4:21 says, "For to me, to live is Christ, and to die is gain." And that was my mom. When she lived for Christ, and she lived hard. She loved God and served God with a passion that, you know, my prayers that I could take on as well. That's part of her legacy, was that she loved the Lord and she walked for Him. And she was real. She wasn't, you know, she wasn't fake. She was genuine. And when she sat and talked with you, you were there. She was there with you. She wasn't like looking out what else is going on. It was only you and her. And you mattered to her at that moment. And her desire was to connect with you so she could connect you with the Lord, like I mentioned before. You know, when she, we had a chance to FaceTime with her the day before she passed. And, you know, we shared a lot of different things. We made also plans, you know, for, she's like, okay, there's this, so we went to a Bible conference not too long before. And she's, hey, that same conference is going on in Kentucky at the, you know, there's this new ark exhibit where they built a life-size ark. So she was excited about the chance to go there. And she's like, yeah, we'll do this. And then when you guys come to Samoa, you can come into my rapture car. Because her brand new car, she always called it her rapture car. Because that was the car, her last car that she was going to have before she goes home to see the Lord. And then we got a new van. She's like, and then I can come over there and check out you guys' new van. You know, my mom had plans still to go on. She didn't know that September 22nd was going to come and the Lord was going to call her home. You know, like Uncle Lai was saying earlier, that tomorrow is not promised to anyone. Proverbs 27 talks about, we don't know what tomorrow holds. You know, don't boast about tomorrow because you don't know what's going to happen tomorrow. Not that my mom was boasting about tomorrow, but she was just making plans that, hey, we're going to do this and this next year. We're going to do this and this and that. But she didn't realize the Lord was going to call her home. Fortunately for my mom, she knew the Lord. She lived wholeheartedly for Him. So even though she passed, you know, it stung, it still hurts because we miss her, miss spending time with her. But we're comforted by the fact that we know she's in heaven. You know, and I remember telling my wife that night after she passed, I was blown away at the fact that the Lord that she served for 44 years, that she just had a heart for, especially, you know, for all of us to see. She met in person, face to face, for the first time that day. That thought blew me away. That thought also comforted me. But it leads me to this question. And oftentimes I remember hearing other people ask the same question. You don't know what's going to happen to you tomorrow. You don't even know what's going to happen to you when you leave this parking lot or when you leave the church. You know, we have a lot of crazy drivers, so that could be a possible end. There's a lot of other things that go on. You can make plans for next year. You can even make plans for tomorrow. But you don't even know if you're going to be here tomorrow. My mom made those plans. And she was ready to go when the Lord called her home. Are you ready to go when the Lord calls you home? Are you one of the guys saying, oh, you know, let me live my life. Let me enjoy life first. And then I'll come back and I'll come to the Lord. You don't know that as you're enjoying life, your life may end. And I'm not trying to be grim. I'm not trying to be, you know, sad or put a wet blanket on everything. But it's the truth. I mean, we're here for my mom, and she thought she was going to, you know, continue on for years to come. Then the Lord called her home, but she was ready. Are you ready? Do you know the Lord? When you get called home, are you going to end up in heaven, or are you not going to end up in heaven? The only way you can go. One of the last times my mom had a chance. Well, not last, but we had a family reunion, and each of the brothers and sisters, Uncle Lion, Uncle May, Auntie Nina, Auntie Omi, Auntie Sheba, them, they all had a chance to share and speak. And what she said is that she got saved. She came to know the Lord. She said the sinner's prayer in September 1977. And she mentioned after that prayer that she said she didn't realize that that was just the start of it. The evidence of a life changed for Christ is the life lived after. A life lived for Christ is a life lived well. That means your life. You know, God's word says, if you love me, keep my commandments. God's telling us, like, hey, if you really call yourself one of mine, I should see it in your life. I should see it how you act, how you treat other people. Are you obeying my word? That's what reflects a life for Christ. And my mom was definitely, she embodied that. She was a life, she wasn't perfect. And she would let you know that when she made her mistakes, but she made things right with the Lord. So when she got called home, we were comforted because we knew she was with the Lord. And I know I keep on going in circles and things, but I just feel it's so important. And one of the things my mom was all about was the gospel. She wanted you to know who God is so that you can have a peace that passes understanding. So that when you're done living here, you know where we're going. You know, God says in his word that he reserves a place and a spot for us. And that spot has been sealed by the Holy Spirit, meaning it's saved for us in heaven, kept by his strength. It says in his word that nobody can take away. It won't rust like things here rust. You may try to build your riches here, but it can get stolen. It can get, you know, it can deteriorate. It can rust and all that stuff. It can be damaged. But the riches we get have in heaven that God keeps, no one can destroy. No one can steal. No one can take away. So I would much rather put my riches and my treasures there where God can protect than to keep it here where moth and especially here, things rust really quick, can be destroyed. So my encouragement and my word for you as I end is check your heart before it's too late. Because you could be out mowing the lawn like my mom and get called home just like that. Make sure your heart is right with the Lord so that we can all celebrate together with my mom in heaven. You know, thank you again for coming. I wish I could say everything else that's in my heart and mind. But thank you also for loving on my mom. Thank you for taking care of us as well as we're here. And as my wife said, it does feel different. It does hit different not coming back to see our parents. My wife's mom just passed away last year as well. And it feels different for both of us. But what helps is all of you and the love that you guys pour into us. So thank you. Seek the Lord before it's too late because you never know when it's our time. Thank you, guys. Yeah. Okay, before we go, we have a song. And if my father-in-law can help me, he's going to help us out. One of the songs that my mom heard my boys sing and play before on our last trip to Hawaii was Besa 92. We're from the old La Mosa Church in Huntington Beach, where my grandfather was the pastor, was a faifa out there. And this is one of the songs we always sang when I grew up. You know, we had loku every night, and even in Cali, even Santa Ana, every night we would have, our besa, and then this is one of the songs we always sang. But my father-in-law came down, and he was stuck with us in Hawaii because of the repatriation flights. And as he was there, I said, okay, let's learn the Psalm 1 song for the boys. And so we're going to share that song with you guys. And, of course, many of you know it, so please sing along once we get there. We'll give them a couple minutes to get ready. But this is my father-in-law, Papalau Inga.
And I thank my son-in-law and my daughter for inviting me to this occasion to help out the grandchildren sing their song. And I wanted to say a few words, but it's one thing I am proud of my son-in-law. You know, we are blessed. At least I am blessed now that the wife is gone and the other grandma is gone, that I have them. They're well, good, and connected to the Lord, and they kept me straight on everything that I do, you know. One thing they told me, that if you're going to speak about the Lord, make sure you back it up with the scripture. So I try to maintain that. After we sing this song that Nate was talking about, I'm also going to sing this one song that me and my grandson wrote 8 years ago, designated for days like this. And basically what the song is that it's like a short story about life, where we're traveling in this world, battling a ship or rowing a boat. And then now one of the oar is broken and the seat is vacant. But we still thank the Lord for all of that. And also one verse to thank Grandma Mary for all the good things she has done, her services and all of that. And lastly, even though that she is gone, we still thank the good Lord for maintaining all of us while we're still traveling in this world. So we'll sing that after this first one. Thank you.
Ready?
going to sing that other song dedicated to Grandma Mary. Zion, hold it. Take it, you raise facial wings. Watch my hands.
Thank you. Ole, mawalunga male, mapuepue, ole maluta we e fo yol maluta pua yole tua. Suola usunga fa fenga sangiao mal fa tua ya shiba. Le lo lo le kalesia. Ai taina ne fo ele. Sa sao mai. Ore po io ai nga io na tu tu chele mai tu tau lange. Pa ia ia wa fanga poto poto ile so la le to io ia si fa ta langa. E va tu fa ta chele la usunga ta ta il sauninga. La usunga fa fa nga nga sangiao mo le avanoa. O se te mi ono fa waula io fa talanga. Tu sai foi molenga nana. Ao wo tu lai. E ne me na ne wo tau mate. In the early, in the late 70s and the early 80s, there was a movement of God in California, especially in Southern California. Among young people, and believe it or not, I was one time a young person. So it was Mary, Oscar, Sheba. This is where I came across in my relationship with Mary. We've known each other for such a long time. And God moved in the hearts of young people, and we met, and this is one of the first times that I could recognize even God moving among the island community of Southern California, that as Samoans, we grew up and we, if someone asks you, do you know the Lord? I say, yes, I know my church. And we always, and of course, they were Mary and was congregational, or the La Mosa as it is known. We had, I'm a Pentecostal background, and we had Methodist, various Samoan community youth that congregated. But we call it youth, but we just call it a chance. Eula vale etangat. But the Lord did something among the young people that I saw and was part of, and I was very blessed to be part of. And I felt at the time there was a breakthrough where even we had great relationship with, like I said, Methodist, Catholic, in the Samoan community, but you know, even our friends of Mormon background, we all got together. We had one common thing that we loved the Lord, but we didn't know how. And we didn't know why. And it was at a point in life that God did something wonderful among us at that time who were growing up in Southern California, the LA, Orange County area. And I say this, maybe God did something wider in the wider scope of things, but we grew up there. I'm speaking primarily out of the Southern California area. And I came across Mary. And Mary, Oscar, and Sheba, and I saw something happen. There was a breakthrough that we were no longer identifying with our denominational banners, but we would identify with the love of Jesus. That became a common denominator for all of us to come together. And we enjoyed this fellowship immensely. We enjoyed this time. So in that back, or in light of that, I grew up in early 80s. Wow, I remember the movement of Calvary Chapel with Pastor Chuck Smith, and more inland in areas like Anaheim, Santa Ana, there was the charismatic movement and all these things that we were so hungry that we were looking for any gathering to go and hear the word of the Lord. And I say that in light of that's how our relationship with Mary and my relationship with Mary was built. Now, fast forward 7 years, all of us take a detour. And a lot of you know me, maybe during that time, took a detour in life. But in relation to Mary, our relationship never detoured. She was always that older sister that I didn't have. She was always personable. She always reached out. And every time I would see Mary, her posture would be, Bob, how are you? How are you doing? Very personable, very. And I enjoyed that. And there's some of you who are sitting here right now who are sitting, but feel compelled to share because of the similar experience that you've experienced with Mary. And even to just maybe a few weeks ago, when before she passed away, we crossed paths at ACE. And she said, Bob, how are you? She knows me by Bob, not by my Matai name. And I love that because he presented a breath of fresh air of really, just knowing that she was genuine. And I sit here this morning and I recognize and I realize that's something I'm compelled to say. She was a very genuine person. And Mary would always reach out whenever we would cross paths. And for that, I just want to be another network of friends and represent some of us who just say that, that was the genuine and it's the Mary that we know and most of you have come to know. We hear a lot of good things said about Mary and none of them can be contested. But Mary was good. Mary was genuine. And when I came across, whenever I see Mary, I can almost expect Sheba to come following. Or when I would see Sheba, I would always expect Mary. And poor Oscar would tag along. And so this is how we built our relationship over the years. So we didn't see each other for a window there, and we met again in Samoa. Nothing changed from our days in Santa Ana, our days in Orange County, in Carson, and those areas. Nothing changed. And for that, I thank you, Mary. I thank you because she was intentional about her relationship with people. She was intentional about her friendship. There was nothing superficial about her in how she came across to me, and I enjoyed that very much in just knowing her. So I've had the pleasure, and I'm proud to say I've known Mary for almost, over 40 years. And there are some friends, individuals that you grew up with, you were close early in life, but now you're older, and then when you make eye contact, you kind of avoid kind of thing. Some of you agree. But, this one friendship I've had, I always look forward when I see Mary so that she can see me and say, how are you doing, Bob? And that I can frankly say, and I can truly say, I praise the Lord for this life. Hey, Yaili. Ele fa upuna fa upunga masangi ai se mava e ngai te mi fa pene. E fa i e sa mo i ona tangata pe a mali liu. I a manuia lau malanga, pe manuia lau malanga. A tono le nei tai au male aso e le fa te tau lea fa upunga i a Mary. Sheba alluded to when she had her BA. Her born-again experience. I believe wale manuianga na malanga Mary maile na vai te mie o maile so. And we can only celebrate the fact o lea wei fatasi balona li. And that in itself is a celebration. Eleto Emmanuel le malanga Mary na manuia mayal malanga Mary. I don't know for your leolo Mary if I le malu itau ya tato ye na ye manuia ai la o malanga. Ina ilo ai tulanga viole li lo soifua mo tato wola. Yeah, ose moli mau pupu le na as a friend. And I glorify God for someone like her in my life. And I've always enjoyed the fellowship with Oscar and the relationship I have with him and Sheba and many of our brothers and sisters here at Calvary Chapel. But most of us, we share mutual, and we do share for certain, the mutual admiration for the Lordship of Jesus Christ over our lives. Ole upo le apostolo Paulo no faile kalesia e kaltia. Awane o tau fiu pe awane iasa la o tau fai melelei. Don't go weary in doing good, especially to the household of faith. Ole olanga nao Mary. She never grew weary in doing good. And I just say thank you for the opportunity to share. Five ta yemanuia le tatu sauninga.
Malo, o tato mai ni tai au, o ne se tasi o tato tina wa maliu. Ya, o tato taulonglongo ma, o tato whaknonoa, ai peitai. Fe mai esu, amu ia e whaknonoa, a wala tau te mawale loto whakmanfanfana. O ne uso, o ne tina. Sau ilo nei tina whawhi o Amalika. Mato mātua ifo o nei tina sanga lue malwha maoni. E le umalano alofa. E tolu mea e sawali ai nei tina o Mary. Mai nei o tusi e koe nito. E sawali ai ia i le alofa whatuatua malwha moe moe. Ai peita i o tolu mea, nei mea tolu, o le alofa e sisili ese. O nei tina e sawali ai e aso umalawa ma le alofa. I knew Mary, I got closer to her when we came here. We introduced ourselves and it was a miracle because she knew my siblings. O nei tina sa iloa ia o uso matua. O a'u o le wi'i o mato a'inga, e sawhwe a'u i le a'inga whai tangaloa. O ma liu umalato o lo swafo o Lisa, e alufwe a'u ia espeta. O lo whai muamua o tuia sopo, a lo whai longolua o Wallace. Ai peitai, e leo o a'u leo tato talanoa iai. Au stato tina, e ngalua a'ia every day. As the scripture says, she's forever redeeming the time. She's always occupying her time. You've heard the many testimonies, especially from her son, Nathan, and her daughter-in-law. E moni mea uma na tautinoino netaeo in netinao Mary. Yes, Matthew 26:13, she will be remembered, the memorial of her hardship. She has endured hardship as a worker. Yes, she has endured hardship as a worker. Faftai ya te oto uma wo mai nei pe ina fai mai se tasi o tato tama yoe e fa manui atu ya tina fatu nei maota fa pe fo'i ya tama Oscar. Maleainga. Watato fatasi name Tina Matua, Tama Matua, or Woma, my fatai would fall in my tato. Fiofium fatasi on a ne Tina, Engalue say oh, while I win a letua. Fatai tile lava. You know, Mary, as I have known her, she was always rejoicing. There's a scripture in the Bible that says, rejoice always. And that's Mary. And as far as I've known Mary, a friend loves at all times. Onetina, she's a real and honorable woman. And that is the truth. Yeah. If Manuatu Yati Oto, Naitama, Matstum, Tina, Matstua, Wo, my Wotatu Fatati, Ne, Tayao, Umane Tato Maftanga, Yetato Wo, Mafia, Mal Oli, Awa, Oni Tina, Elim Fang and Alunimu, she cannot be forgotten. She cannot be forgotten. She has the word of God in her. Pastor Oscar, God bless you. From Manuel to Yati Oil, Malfatuya Bathsheba, Moto Usom Tuangane, Ma Tofine Fanao. Nathan and Deborah, God bless you. Lysenge and all of you. Lena, wow, I miss this woman. I don't want to stand here and cry. She was my advocate. She was my mentor. She will always be remembered. Proverbs 17:17, a friend loves at all times, and a brother is born for adversity. If manui atu yate oto uma watato fatasi ne tayao. So if we mo in manui.
I think we can go on even much longer. So I'm going to give it another 5 minutes, and then I will close with a message in our closing song. So praise the Lord. Amen. How's everybody? Everybody good? Praise the Lord. God bless you.
Good morning, brothers and sisters.
Good morning.
Well, this is a pleasant surprise for me. I thought we were wrapping it up until Reverend Oscar said, I'll give you 5 more minutes. And I did not think I would be on the program. But when you're invited that way, you take the opportunity, whenever invited, to get up and share your testimony. As we listened, we know that Sister Mary was a very, very ministering person. And I felt it was important that I get up and share my testimony. Well, it's almost afternoon, but still morning. My name is Sola Ita. I am Mary's first cousin on her mother's side. My mother is older, and I'm a little bit older than Mary. So, like, she bossed all her sisters around, but I have an older sister than me, so I can't boss everybody around. But I'm really happy to be here at this time. And I too would like to say, we live to die, and we die to live. And so this is a very happy day because we're all here because the Lord wants us to live lives that will allow us to return and live in His presence one day. How we live in this life will decide where we will go in the next life. And life here is temporary. And I loved all the messages. If you love God, keep my commandments. Very simple. My husband tells me every morning, I'm old, don't speak to me anymore about this and that. You're old. I'm old too. He says, look, I'm almost 82. I said, well, I'm almost 104. And so I said, our goal is to be happy. And I believe, and this is my testimony, when you live the gospel of Jesus Christ, you're going to be happy. Simply live the gospel of Jesus Christ, whatever denomination we may be. I know that God lives. Jesus Christ is His only begotten Son. And because of the atonement, you and I live. And all we need to do, because we do make mistakes, and we are all imperfect. We are all imperfect children of our Heavenly Father. And because of the atonement, you and I can repent. I have 6 children, 20 grandchildren, and they all live in the great place of America. And of course, I don't have anyone here to do my fails. So I have to do all the fails for myself and for my 82-year-old husband. And when I speak to my children, I say, well, we pray for your safety and remember R&R. So they're thinking, I'm saying to them, what is it, retreat and whatever it is? I says, no, it's repent and return. To all of you who that applies to, please do so. And to those who don't apply, I thank you. And they go, oh, here she goes. It's to my children and my grandchildren. I love them. I love all of you. And that's why I have to remind her. I remind myself, too, that everyone is a child of our Heavenly Father. And you know what's really funny sometimes? This is my husband. The police is about to stop us. So I said, what are you going to say when the police stops you? Because you didn't stop. I'll look at him and I'll say, do you know who I am? I said, I hope you don't say that. But if he does come and say to you, do you know who I am? Then you say, I am a child of God. And then he won't get mad. Because in the world we live in, pride is a very common thing. And I try to remind my husband to beware of pride and strip ourselves of pride, because even the little animals have pride. And if we can strip ourselves of pride and beware of pride, we can't help but love one another. And I said, the first commandment is to love the Lord with all thy heart, might, mind, and strength. And the second is to love thy neighbor as thyself. And when we do that, everything will be at peace. So it's my prayer, brothers and sisters, and thank you for allowing me to share my testimony today. Because Sister Mary, whenever we met, we would always talk about obeying the commandments and being Christ-like and being kind to everybody. Because you don't take anything with you. You leave all the land behind. You leave all your money behind. You leave your house, fancy house, your titles. You just take your goodness and your personal righteousness. And that is my goal, and that is my prayer for all of us here today. And I'm so grateful that my sister, dear Mary, is on the other side waiting for all of us. So how we live here today, how we treat each other, is to be remembered always. I say all these things in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen.
Testes.
I would like to thank everybody for your wonderful sharing for Sister Mary. Having known Mary all these years, there were so many different stories I could tell you. So as I was back there listening to everyone, I said, Lord, what are the ones that I need to share? Mary had that sort of uncanny type of personality, and God could use her in any situation. Mary was our icebreaker. She had this way of segueing into any conversation, regardless of the subject. She had that God-given gift of personality because Mary was a soul winner. And God had saved her for that purpose. That is the gift that he'd given her. And so whatever ways that God arranged for her to meet people, it was always a lasting impression. She got to know the guys at the local the gas station near our house in a very strange way. She pulled up in there one day and give me $20 gas. So they put the gas in the car. And then she realized she didn't have $20. And so when the guy came, she said, hey, all of my. And she started, you know what? My brother-in-law will be back here in 10 minutes. And he'll come and bring the $20. Okay? All right? Thank you so much. I love you. God bless you. Bye. He'll be here. Don't worry. He'll be here. And so she got to meet them. The guy, I could just imagine the guy at the gas station was like. And she would have situations like that and meet people. And, you know, they would just laugh. Of course, you know, I had to show up and pay the $20. But there's so many things like that. One time in, she was late to catch a plane in Los Angeles. You know, the Los Angeles International Airport. And she got there. And, you know, they give you something like, you have to be there so much time before they actually start boarding the flight. So she knew she was late. She got in. She went right up to the counter, the ticket counter. So glad that she made it on time and was able to get her ticket. And when she turned around, she noticed there was a long line that was waiting for the ticket counter. She cut in front of everybody to get to the ticket counter. And she realized it at that moment. And then she turned around, she walked out, and she goes, go Lakers! She was in Los Angeles. And so that was Mary. She had that sort of goofiness where she could be goofy when you needed goofy. But in all of that, God had used that to open up doors for her to share the things that were so important in her life. As you heard some of the testimonies, and as I segue into the message, in the fall of 1977, God had gathered three preacher's kids. You know, their parents were 5 feet tall. And God saved them and gave them that born-again experience. They had been together then after that for 11 years. In 1988, two of them came to Samoa. 8 years later, God brought them all back together again, the three of them. And in a home, God had laid upon their heart all the things, the journeys that they had gone, the things that they had learned about God. They started a work for him, trusting and believing that God was faithful to his promises. They experienced it in their lives. And so it was on that day in February 1996, Calvary Chapel of Samoa began. Turn with me, if you would, to Titus chapter 2, verse 13. The verse says, looking for that blessed hope and that glorious appearing of the great God and our Savior, Jesus Christ. Father, we thank you for the gathering here today. And God, we pray that your word as it goes forth, Lord,
We know that it will not return void, but that people would receive and open their hearts, O God, as you would bring them and give them your invitation. So, God, we commit this to you as we give thanks in Jesus' name. And everybody says? Amen. So in our passage, verse 13, looking for that blessed hope, that glorious hope, the hope that Jesus will once again appear. And as he appears, the scripture goes on to tell us that we will be with him. What a wonderful hope, a blessed hope. As I was looking at that verse of scripture, the one word that stuck out the most was hope. What is hope? What does hope mean? What does it mean to you? How does it relate to us today? To define the word hope, that assurance that something will come to pass. Hope is that assurance that a promise will be fulfilled. We hope for a better tomorrow. We hope things will be better in the world. After so many years of hoping in these things, we come to realize that the world is not getting that much better. Many of us talk about, I can't wait till things come back to normal again. Last year in 2020, we'd never had a year like 2020 in all of our lives. It was a year to remember. And after it was over, we were all thinking, oh, we pray and hope for a better year, a better time. But now we hear that there is what is called a Delta variant of the COVID-19. And we also hear of the Omicron variant that's discovered recently in South Africa. We hear that there are more lockdowns that are coming, that happened in different places around the world. And you can understand the effect of these lockdowns and all of these things that are having, not only in society, but in the economy and the welfare, the mental state of peoples. So in many places, people are pushing back. Why? We say, where's hope? What do we have to hope in today? Well, we have our family, we have our health, we have all this. But didn't you hear the testimonies today? What do you know? How do you know what's going to happen when you leave this place? How do you know what's going to happen tonight? Do you know what tomorrow holds for you? You can say, well, I hope. With all these things that are going on, where is hope? Hope is that assurance that something good is going to happen. But when you read the headlines in the papers, when you hear of the things that are being spoken of, that are being highlighted, where's the hope? And our children today, a great and strong influence that is moving through our island society. The crime rate is increasing. Drug problems increase as well. I say, why bring these things up now at this time? Young people are looking for escape. Where's the hope for today? Where's the hope for tomorrow? There are many that are seeking academia and trying to be successful in their careers. But when you reach that mountaintop, when you reach that, then what? Then what is next? For a moment, for a time, you will be happy, you will be content. But for how long? Until you will say, there must be another mountain I can climb. One of the wealthiest men in the world at his time, and relating today, a man by the name of Rockefeller was asked, how much money is enough? His answer was, just a little bit more. Where is hope? Those three preacher's kids had the hope of Jesus Christ. From the time that we got saved in 1977 all the way to 1980, we experienced so much. And thank you, Pastor Bob, for coming and sharing up about the 70s and the 80s. Many of you don't even know what the 70s, 80s were like. But thank you. I know there's someone here who can relate. There was a great move of God, as he shared. And there's a great move of God today. One of hope. Sister Mary was one who believed in this hope so much that she gave it all up for the hope in Jesus Christ. You heard how she was always reaching out to people. Brother Lai shared his testimony how, why at this time would she make all this appropriations to visit all of these people? The thing that fueled her drive, the thing that drove her, is that she knew that she was going to heaven, but she wanted you to be there with her. She wanted to be sure that everyone that she spoke with, everyone that she knew, that you would be there with her as well. She never thought that in September was going to be her final time. We all planned to be together in the rapture, but that was not God's plan. For 28 years, she lived her life, and most of it to please Mary, to please what Mary wanted, until in the latter end of that 28th year, in the fall of September 1977, she surrendered her life to Christ. And for the next 44 years, she committed to reach many for Christ. She had something so precious, something so amazing that she experienced, that we all experience who abide and walk in Christ and know his love and power. She had a joy unspeakable and full of glory, a peace that passes understanding. She had these things, and she wanted her family, her friends, and everyone that she met to know the gifts that God had given her. It was hope, a blessed hope. One you will not find in the things of the world today. One you will not find in any venture, whether academia, whether in business, whatever it may be. You will not find this. So that's why in our passage, it says, looking for that blessed hope. That assurance that something will come to pass. That assurance that a promise will be fulfilled. You look around you, see these Christmas decorations. Christmas was her favorite time of the year. Many of ours as well. And why do we celebrate Christmas? Why do we gather on Christmas? Well, it's a tradition. But you know the reason why we all talk about the birth of Jesus Christ. Let's look at that real quickly. Matthew 1:19. There quickly we had so many, and they're coming, all the Christmas plays and whatnot. Joseph, Mary's husband, being a just man and not willing to make her an example, was minded to put her away privately. Mary was with child, and they hadn't really gotten married yet. And this was going on, and she was thinking, well, I don't know if I should go with this. And he was having his doubts, and I don't know, you know. And then look what it says in verse 20. It says, but while he was thinking on things, the angel of the Lord appeared to Joseph in a dream, saying, thou son of David, fear not to take unto you Mary for your wife. For that which is conceived in her is of the Holy Ghost. It was the working of God through the angel he spoke to Joseph, who was concerned, and he was really worried, but he was concerned also about Mary and what would happen. You know, this sort of would be a scandal and all of that. But when the angel spoke to him, he got peace. Verse 21, he will bring forth a son, and you will call his name Jesus, for he shall save his people from their sins. Now in verse 23, behold, a virgin shall be with child and shall bring forth a son, and they shall call his name Emmanuel, which means interpreted God with us. Look at that. We all know that story. Say, yeah, it's exciting. It's beautiful. But that verse 23 was the fulfillment of a prophecy, or will be, that was given 700 years before this day, before the day that angel spoke to Joseph. 700 years, God promised, God gave his word that he was going to send his son, a child born of a virgin in a manger. Wow, 700 years before, and now it actually happens. Remember the meaning of hope? The assurance that something will come to pass. The assurance that a promise will be fulfilled. God gave his word in Isaiah 7:14. God gave a promise that he would send, and it came to pass. Do you know that in the Bible, historically speaking, you can check the accounts, check the records, that before it ever happened, God told King Nebuchadnezzar of the Babylonian Empire, he told them before it would happen that the Medes and the Persians were going to conquer you. And then after the Medes and the Persians, the Greeks will conquer the Medes and the Persians. Before it ever happened. And then he said, and the Romans will conquer the Greeks. Now, if you were there at that time, you would probably laugh, what in the world is going on? But when you follow history, it happened exactly the way that God said it was going to happen. What does that tell us? It tells us that the assurance that something will come to pass, God said it was going to happen, and it happened. The assurance that a promise will be fulfilled, and that promise was fulfilled. You see, brothers and sisters, family, friends, loved ones, guests, this was Mary's hope. This is our hope. Because God had made promises for you and I today. Let's look at John chapter 14. Jesus said, let not your heart be troubled. You believe in God, believe also in me. Verse 2. In my Father's house are many mansions. I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go to prepare a place for you, verse 3, I will come again. He made a promise. God has never gone back on his promise. Everything that God said was going to happen has happened. Jesus makes a promise, and he says that in my Father's house are many mansions. If it wasn't so, I wouldn't tell you. I'm going to prepare a place for you. And if I go prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you unto myself. That where I am, there you may be also. These are the promises that we stand on. These are the promises because we know that whatever God says, it's going to happen. God has never failed yet, and he never will. Where is hope today? What are you hoping in today? Are you hoping in your career? Are you hoping in your relationship? Are you hoping in the things that belong to you, your material possessions? How long will that last in your material possessions until you need the new model? Until you need the new upgrade that's going to cost you a little bit of money? And things will always continue to change. The thing that you must understand about our world, it always changes. There are things that are going on today that we never thought would ever happen. But lo and behold, those things that we used to call evil, today they call it good. Those things that we called good back in the day, they call it evil. And it's all acceptable in our society. God never changes. For 700 years, he held true to his word. And he's 100% accurate. Somebody said, well, Jesus was just talking to his disciples. He wasn't talking to any of us. He references 1 Corinthians 15. That same promise is there in 15. Behold, I show you a mystery. We will not all sleep, but we shall all be changed. In a moment, a twinkling of an eye, at the last trump, for the trumpet will sound and the dead in Christ shall rise. And we will be changed. But this corruptible must put on incorruption, and this mortal must put on immortality. The Apostle Paul, who wrote that, also wrote in 1 Thessalonians 4:16. Say, Pastor, what's with all the word? What's with all these passages? So that you will see. These are not my words. All of the things that I'm speaking about today, that you heard about today, these are God's words. These are words that he's written for all of you. Do you know that the Bible is God's love letter to you? The Bible tells us how much God really loves us. Do you know how much God loves you? I hear so many people saying, God is good. God is good all the time. All the time, God is good. They go and make hell in other people's lives during the week. And they're just saying, God is good all the time. God is good. But if you truly know the goodness of God, your life will change. Because a saved life, a born-again life, not only is transformed, but it is a changed life. 1 Thessalonians 4:18, Paul says, comfort one another with these words. When we were preparing for the service, the family were trying to get all these videos together, and they were going through a lot of, so many pictures. Wow. Over 40 years worth of pictures. Okay. Trying to get these videos and these sounds. Wow. And every picture that I saw, Sister Mary, would just bring a tear to my eye. Wow. We began this work together, three, united, bonded. We believed what God said he would do, and he has done. God has been so true to his word. 1 Thessalonians says, comfort one another with these words. I'm comforted because I know where Mary is. I'm comforted because I know what she has done will not fall to the ground. For many of your lives have been touched. And God wants to use that as a stepping stone for doing wonderful and marvelous things in your life, if you will only open up to him. You see, what we learned so many years ago, we thought we were Christians because we were preachers' kids. You know, it's kind of like an automatic thing. Well, my father's a faithful, and so yeah. But Mary didn't get saved till she was 28. Sheba and I were 22. We spent all of our lives going to church. We spent all of our lives, we were part of the Alpha Pese. You know, we were part of those groups, you know, that we go to those gatherings where there's competitions and it's all about, number one, kako. You know, and it was all about, you know, how good do you look and all of these things. And, we thought this was it until we met Jesus Christ. Until we met Jesus Christ in the fall of 77. It changed everything. We realized that we thought we knew him, but it was all up here, and it was not in the heart. 18 inches of difference makes all the difference in the world. And the message for you today is that you may know Christ up here, but do you know him in here? For all those years of our lives, we knew him here. We thought we believed and we thought we had faith in, but we realized we didn't until we accepted him here. Because the Bible tells us it's out of the heart comes the issues of life. Let me close with this passage in 1 John 3, verse 1. John writes and he says to the church, to you, to me, to all of us, behold what manner of love the Father has given to us, that we should be called the sons of God. What a glorious designation. What a glorious privilege. Therefore, the world knows us not, because it knew him not. Beloved, verse 2, now are we the sons and daughters of God, if you would. It does not yet appear what we shall be. But we know that when Christ will appear, we shall be like him. We shall see him as he is. This echoes the same sentiment of Jesus in John 14. In my Father's house are many mansions. I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go to prepare a place for you, I will come again to receive you unto myself, that where I am, there you may be also. And every man that has this hope, every man and woman that has this hope, what hope? The hope of Jesus Christ in our hearts, in your heart. Every person that has this hope purifies himself even as he is pure. The question is, are you ready today? If your understanding, your relationship with Jesus is up here, I have to say, sorry, my friend, that's not going to cut it. We'll say, well, how do you know? Because over 20 years of my life, it was all up here in my head until I accepted him into my heart. That's where it begins. Let me ask you, are you ready? Are you ready? Do you know Jesus Christ as your Lord? I'm going to ask the worship team to come up. We had done several funerals here at church. And every time I say, I pray, this is the last one I have to do, because I'm looking forward to his coming. And I want to say it again, I hope this is the last one that we have to do, because I know that I'm ready. And I know that she beat us to it, and she's waiting for us. Let's pray. Father, thank you so much, God, for your goodness and your glory. Thank you, God, for your word that you said you would not allow to return back to you void. When your word goes out, it will accomplish what you want it to. There are many here today, many that are listening, Lord, watching over the internet. You have touched their hearts, God. You have pulled on their heartstrings. And they realize at this very moment that Jesus Christ is not in their hearts. Oh God, today, may today be the beginning of a new journey, a new venture of faith for all of these, Father. Enrich them, we pray. Encourage them, God, in every way, Lord, that they might know, Father, your Son, in a most glorious, personal, and intimate way. In Jesus' name.
For your mercy never fails me. All my life I've been held in your hand. From the moment that I wake up until I lay my head down, I will sing of the goodness of God. I love you, Lord, for your mercy never fails me. All my life I've been held in your hand. The moment that I wake up until I lay my head down, I will sing of the goodness of God.
Here we go.
All my life you have been. All my life you have been so, so good. And every breath that I am able, I will sing of the goodness of God. I love your voice. You have led me through the fire. Like no other, I've known you as a father, I've known you as a friend, and I will sing of the goodness of God.
Sing it now.
And all my life you have been faithful, and all my life you have been so, so good. I will sing of the goodness. Father, thank you. Before God, we give it over to our family representative to share his announcements and close before the recessional. What a wonderful gathering, God, that you give us your favor in holding back the rain and giving us, Lord, this time. We are so grateful, God, and so thankful. We pray, Father, your word says that one plants, one waters, God, but you give increase. Oh, God, our prayer, grant so much increase today amidst all those that are gathered and all those listening. Increase, God, their faith, turning, God, their lives to Jesus. Father, you said that none can come to him except you draw them. Oh God, we pray by your mercies and grace, make it so. Make it so. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. Would you give him glory?
Yeah.
Mano lava long side. Tato Fabo Tonga and Nate to Lalas. A leaf out me a voice from Chalang with the tone of fella foile, the fella who owe me for ill tato. So Ginga and yes. Yeah. Muliatu Langang Fab Tail of Sung and Fabbing. Messe foile, Malun Tanga and Wen. Now for Pes. Yet to soy for you up for the yaw. Yeah, and Messe foy fat man from Fango Ain. Yeah. Tu si na ifol fola ngai ya ta tonu le u ma fang fang ai ai nga na lua e mesi fo e ma to paolo ta tonu o le u pulen sa fol fola ta to tu ma ele e fa pe nga tinga ya mari e nga u ma fo ya ta to i lai so i fo ma ngai bai taim sa ele sta to ma ftang ma ta to ali ya e fa no ma so fo mo ta to u ma nga lu se fam te lang fa pe ngai pa io ai nga Mese o tātou paolo. A mae ale sau nginga le sunga le faipe au. Ia. Wala o atu maise luas fulu minute se fa ma vai ele. Le tātou a inga. Ke loa ingi si uftau mai. Ia. Or kou kai me lea. Fai le tātou fa ma vai inga. Ia nga ume loa na ia nga pungi akule le pusa. Le tina. Ia nga mon modi atu le tino i oi. Li pingi. Mele ile aunga manglele, olonga inga la faye ile, so inga mulmuli, ya ita otori tina. Bala alo atule, pa ia, mbalwa kako ainga, tu tele matuta ulangi, mese kutato paolo. Ya, ole, maota lea, meri le la faye ile, tuwe sa unginga. Ta alo atu mafalo alo, ay mese feila ufenga nwenga, tofile tua, ya tato fatasi o, amaea. Ngaila ye se tau maftanga o tapenga le ainga. Ia mo tatou. Le ngā te ngā, ye fo I faro longa le ainga. E wha uma es mātou wham talanga I o. Ar pa ia ma lasi lasi. Wō me māsan. Le el tatou whātasi ne yas. Lo ye fo li tau maftanga le ile tūan mali o tau. Ia ma le vai mālu. Ia o taluai itali eile. Le nge yasu wa level le rātou maftanga I tau. Ia le nge yasu. If I fall in inga le tua. Ya, was me to sang al tatu, ainga patatus, tu watu yole, eli pinge, eli titi yole lotu artina. Ya ole awala foi, ya fale ton, a fai eso insurance, wo uman tongi, e kava ele hanga lo tavare se tulo. Ya, leo avu wapela awala. Ai, morsil fear tatu ainga, ya, kanwaele kiki kako. Fale yo, ya, mele talo a kulpa ia mal madu, ya, ati ngia maile, ton sanga, ati ngai a inga, ya, anu es ma fom talanga, ya, manguia li tato fa boi moe, li ngia fias, ya, say fua.
As Brother Pati, would you please come up and if you could play and we're going to give you this last, what, did he say 20 or did he say 10? He said, you may come up and do your
Some of you didn't get a chance, so we're going to give you that now, and then we're going to close. Thank you.
the burial has a tent. Okay, we're out early.
Water spot.
Move it over.
More. Did you guys turn it around? Heads here. In the midst of life, we are in death. From whom can we seek help? Our help is in the name of the Lord, who made heaven and earth. God, who raised Christ from the dead, will give life to your mortal bodies also through the Spirit that dwells in you. Listen, for I tell you a mystery. We will not all die, but we will all be changed. For this corruptible must put on incorruption, and this mortal body must put on immortality. Then the saying that is written will be fulfilled. Death is swallowed up in victory. Where, O death, is your victory? Where, O death, is your sting? But thanks be to God, who gives us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. Let us pray. O God, you have ordered this wonderful world and know all things in earth and in heaven. Give us such faith that by day and by night, at all times and all places, we may commit without fear ourselves and those dear to us, to your never-failing love in this life and in the life to come. Amen. Jesus said, "Very truly, I tell you, unless a grain of wheat falls into the earth and dies, it remains just a single grain. But if it dies, it bears much fruit. Those who love their life will lose it, And those who hate their life in this world will keep it for eternal life. Whoever serves me must follow me, Jesus said. And where I am, there you may be also. Whoever serves me, the Father will honor. Almighty God, into your hands we commend your daughter, Mary, in sure and certain hope of resurrection to eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. This body we commit to the ground, earth to earth, ashes to ashes, dust to dust. Blessed are the dead who die in the Lord. Yes, says the Spirit, they will rest from their labors, for their deeds follow them. At that final trumpet sound, that voice of the archangel, when the dead in Christ shall arise, Sister Mary, we will all be together again. Amen. Amen.
Over 50 years, or eco 50. Yo, Angulu. Oh, okay.
Wait.